Inshallah, we're going to start off the halaqa with recitation by Sheikh Ra'ad.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم فسبحان الله حين تمسون وحين تصبحون وله الحمد في السماوات والأرض وحين تظهرون يخرج الحي من الميت ويخرج الميت من الحي ويحيي الأرض بعد موتها وكذلك تخرجون ومن آياته أن خلقكم من تراب ثم إذا أنتم بشر تنتشرون ومن آياته أن خلق لكم من أنفسكم أزواجا خلق لكم من أنفسكم أزواجا لتسكنوا إليها وجعل بينكم مودة ورحمة إن في ذلك لآيات لقوم يتفكرون صدق الله العظيم.
So before he starts, actually today I just want to let everyone know there is a translation from English, موجود. Whoever wants translation or knows somebody who doesn't understand English, Brother Mustafa here is translating the halaqa from English to Arabic, inshallah. So with that, further ado, I'll have Sheikh Ra'ad start, inshallah.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين اللهم صل وسلم وبارك وانعم على سيدنا وحبيبنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Dear brothers and sisters, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. MashaAllah, as you can see, successful marriage. It is very, very nice topic, right? We will see inshaAllah Azza wa Jal if we have successful marriages, and inshaAllah we hope everyone inshaAllah has successful marriage inshaAllah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Now, before I start, I saw the video, which is, what it's called? Halal marriage? Something like that?
Made easy.
Huh? Halal made easy? Right?
Marriage made easy.
And mashallah tabarakallah, I liked it so much. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward all the brothers who acted And Brother Hassan, يعني, who started this, and I really would like to congratulate Brother Rayan. Where's Rayan? So congratulations, brother. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala يعني, give you more inshallah, happiness in your new life, inshallah. And Brother Abu Muhammad, the father of the of the bride. Okay, ikhwani. Now, I will not address this topic as a fiqh issues, okay? I will not address any fiqh issues in this topic because I believe before like one week or two weeks, one of your halaqas here, Sheikh Ahmad, may Allah reward him, he addressed all the, you know, issues in marriage, right? So basically, I will speak about, you know, how we can create and establish and have a successful marriage in our life. Now, most of these points that you will see inshallah azza wa jal, it is from two things. Number one, from my personal experience, and then from, you know, the stories that I was involved in it in my life here in America and in my country. You know, as Imam and Sheikh, we have, you know, a lot of problems in our community and we have to be involved in it. And subhanAllah, that's how you, you know, establish your experience and, you know, to put it together to benefit the community, inshaAllah Azza wa Jal. Now, successful marriage. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ أَنْ خَلَقَ لَكُمْ مِنْ أَنْفُسِكُمْ أَزْوَاجًا لِتَسْكُنُوا إِلَيْهَا وَجَعَلَ بَيْنَكُمْ مَوَدَّةً وَرَحْمَةً إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَاتٍ لِقَوْمٍ يَتَفَكَّرُونَ. I will, in the beginning, introduce or give introduction about marriage, you know, how marriage is important, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addressed, you know, this topic in the Quran, how the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam addressed this topic, you know, in his life and among his companions, okay? And after that we will see how we can have successful marriage inshaAllah azza wa jal. First of all, ikhwani, the ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and among his signs is this, that he created for you mates from among yourselves, that you may dwell in tranquility with them, and he has put love and mercy between your hearts. Verily, in that are signs for those who reflect. Now, what we can take from this ayah? Number one, ikhwani, look how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, says this ayah. وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ, from his signs, that he created for you mates from among yourselves. Yourselves. So when you know that my wife exactly like me and she is apart from me, then I really will do my best to make my relationship very successful, right? I will not put her down. I will respect her because she is exactly like me. She is a human being like me exactly. She has feelings like me exactly. So I have to understand this. Now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know, gave us the reason why he gave us, wives. Why he gave us females, litaskunu, to have tranquility. What tranquility mean, ikhwani? Tranquility, what this means? This means, I will not feel safe, I will not feel happy, okay, if I am not in my home. When I go to my home, I should feel relaxed, I should be relaxed, I should feel very, 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 you know, good when I be with my wife.
not the opposite. Because we have some people, you know, in the opposite way, right? They just keep, you know, being outside the home because they don't want to involve or engage with their wives, right? Let me ask you, who here is single? Raise your hand. Let me count. No, really, raise your hand. MashaAllah, I know some people who are singles, you know, and they didn't raise their hand. What this mean? Sisters? Just one? Oh my God. Okay. Alhamdulillah. The married, please. Raise your hand. The married. Sisters, brothers, I know you, by the way. So don't play games with me. Okay, alhamdulillah. Fine. So, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala puts the reason. What is the reason? What is the reason? Can you see it? By the way, can you see this clearly? Okay, so what is the reason?
Tranquility.
Tranquility, right? And then from that tranquility, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala puts the results and showed us the result that we can achieve after that, which is the love and the mercy. The love and the mercy. Let me ask you this question. And by the way, I don't want make this lecture as, you know, lecturing you, but I really hope, you know, to share with me, and I will give you some space, inshallah, to give me, you know, your comments. If you want to add anything, inshallah, azza wa jal, maybe يعني be helpful, inshallah, to everyone, bi'idhnillah tabarak wa ta'ala. Okay? So, if we don't have tranquility, ikhwani, can we achieve, can we have love and mercy? Ask me. Can we?
No.
Yes or no?
No.
No. Because this is number one, which is to have second. Please memorize and understand this. Second, okay? Comfort. If I don't have, because honey, this is the assess, this is the root of our topic for today. If you don't have the comfort in your house, okay, you will not feel any love. You will lose, you know, the love, you will lose the mercy. Okay? Fine. So this is number one, and this is, ikhwani, very important. I want you to remember this ayah. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَاللَّهُ جَعَلَ لَكُم مِّنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ أَزْوَاجًا. And Allah has made for you mates and companions of your own nature. وَجَعَلَ لَكُمْ مِنْ أَزْوَاجِكُمْ بَنِينَ وَحَفَدًا. And made for you out of them sons and daughters and grandchildren, and provided for you sustenance of the best. Will they then believe in vain things and be ungrateful for Allah's favors? رَزَقَكُمْ مِنَ الطَّيِّبَاتِ أَفَبِالْبَاطِلِ يُؤْمِنُونَ وَبِنِعْمَةِ اللَّهِ هُمْ يَكْفُرُونَ. So this is another value. This is why the marriage is very important, to create and to increase the ummah, the numbers of the believers. Okay? And if we don't have this kind of relationship, if we don't have, you know, wives and husbands, we will not create this. Okay. Now, عن ابن مسعود عن عبد الله بن مسعود رضي الله تعالى عنه قال قال لنا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يا معشر الشباب من استطاع منكم الباءة فليتزوج فإنه أغض للبصر وأحصن للفرج ومن لم يستطع فعليه بالصوم فإنه له وجاء. Now the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, all you young men, whoever is able to marry should marry, for that will help him to lower his gaze and guard his modesty. So that's why, ikhwani, marriage is very important. And now I don't want to talk about, you know, the, as I said, the fiqh issues when the marriage is obligation, when the marriage is mubah, when the, you know, the marriage is mustahab. I don't want to touch these things because I think Sheikh Ahmed already covered it. But this showed us the importance of the zawaj, of this relationship. Why? Because it helped me to, you know, to lower my gaze and to protect myself from the haram. Okay, ikhwani and akhwati? Now, by the way, if you are not following with me, you will not be able to follow me after, because this introduction very, very important, inshallah. And in the other hadith, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, marriage is my sunnah, whosoever keeps away from it is not from me. Okay? And this is hadith, by the way, based on a story that three men of his companions went to the house of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to ask about, you know, his act worship. How the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is dealing with this, you know? And he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wasn't in the house. So they asked Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. And she, you know, told them what she knew about the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then they thought that, you know, they are doing more than the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They thought that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam shouldn't, you know, sleep. Shouldn't, you know, eat, he should, you know, fast a lot and, you know, just pray a lot and as these things. And then when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam heard about what they said, okay, he, you know, stood up and called the companions and he said, some people, he didn't, you know, look at them even, okay, he didn't expose them. He said, some people say this and that. But for me, I eat, okay, and fast at the same time. I, you know, sleep and pray qiyam, and I marry a woman. And this is my sunnah, this is my way. Whoever want it, so follow it. And who reject it will not be among my ummah. And this is, ikhwani, very important. Now, what I did? I divided marriage to three stages. Okay? I divided marriage to three stages. What are they? Number one, the period before the engagement, al-khutubah, and then the engagement, and then after the engagement, which is the real marriage. Right? In these three stages, if we have healthy, you know, thoughts, healthy way, full understanding in every period, inshallah, we will succeed in our marriage bi-idhnillah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Okay? And again, as I said in the beginning, a lot of these points from what? From my personal experience, and then from all the stories that I was involved in them. Now, before the engagements, the first question that you should ask yourself, what is my intention? Okay? Now you are one to get married. The first question, what is my intention? Why I want to get married? Why I want to look for, you know, my girlfriend or dream girl? Why? Why want to do that? In addition, what I mentioned before, again, I told you, remember the ayat and the hadith. I would like to add something very important. عن أنس بن مالك رضي الله تعالى عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا تزوج العبد فقد كمل نصف الدين فليتق الله في النصف الباقي قال الألباني في صحيح الترتيب والترهيب حسن لغيره. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said in the hadith, when a man marries, he has fulfilled half of his religion, so let him fear Allah regarding the remaining half. So this is very important. So basically what you are doing, you are fulfilling something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered you to do, right? This number one. So what is my intention? Because ikhwani, based on my intention, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will provide you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you. وَعَلَى نِيَاتِكُمْ تُرْزَقُونَ. Right? And then something very important, make dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide you to find the right wife or husband for you. And ikhwani, dua is very important. And by the way, dua is very important not just for, you know, getting a wife or a husband, but in everything. In everything. You have to make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that, oh Allah, give me the right person. Oh Allah, give me the right person. Now the question, what if you have good intention and you made a lot of dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide you to the right person, male or female, and in the end you have, you know, a bad person? What do you consider this? We consider this a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Will you able to be patient and deal with it based on Allah's orders, or you will deal with it in the opposite way? So this is very, very important, ikhwan wa khawati. So dua is very important. And then take all the halal means. So you are now looking for what? A wife or a husband, right? So take all the halal, and if you pay attention, I put, you know, a line under halal, right? Messages and text messages and emails, my love, you know, these, that, you know, all these things, the opposite of the word, right? Halal, haram, right? It's number one. And by the way, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us what are the halal ways, you know, to take in order to find the spouse, inshallah, or the wife or the husband, inshallah, azza wa jal. Now, so this is very important. Now, who should I choose? Who should I choose? And this question usually what? Usually, you know, goes to the men's side. Who should I choose? The wealthy, the, you know, the girl that has good car, or they has, mashallah, very good family, or the one who is, mashallah, very religious, or what? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith, تُنْكَحُ الْمَرْأَةُ لِأَرْبَعْ لِمَالِهَا وَلِحَسَبِهَا وَلِجَمَالِهَا وَلِدِينِهَا فَاغْفَرْ بِذَاتِ الدِّينِ تَرِبَتْ يَدَكَ. So the Prophet ﷺ said in the hadith, women are married for four, which means for four reasons. Her family, number one. Her beauty, number two. And her religion, number three, her wealth. So succeed with the one with religion, may your hands be in the dust. Which means, the last sentence means, may you be impoverished if you ignore this warning. Okay? Because in the end, if you didn't choose the right person, okay, it will guide you and lead you to the poverty in your life. Financially, but financially it might be one of these things, but, you know, mentally or emotionally, a lot of, you know, things might happen if you didn't, you know, choose your spouse based on the iman. Okay? And khwani, wallahi al-azim, this is something very important for you sisters and for you brothers. Now, let me be honest with you. We who came from overseas, maybe we have, you know, some points, you know, different than the brothers or the sisters who born here or raised here, right? Which is something normal. Why? Because the culture. But ikhwani, we have one common things, because we are Muslims, one common things, which is, if we really fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we should follow His commands. We should focus on what He advised us. And the advice was to, you know, focus on the religion. This does not mean, don't look at the beauty, don't look at, you know, the other things, but make the religion number one in your heart. Make the religion, you know, the first one in your priority. And by the way, when I say religion, it doesn't mean how many prayer sister you are praying, how many juzuk you are memorizing. Oh brother, do you memorize the Quran? How many rak'ah you pray every day? How many days you fast? Because we don't choose, okay, the religion based on these questions. The religion is, you know, the way of life. The way of life. Do you apply our religion in your life? That's the question. Right? That's the question. Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu, a lot of companions were praying more than Abu Bakr, were fasting more than Abu Bakr, but Abu Bakr was number one after the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Why? Because he understood his religion and then he applied this religion in his heart. He trusts Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in every matter in his life. That's the religion, ikhwani. Okay? That's the religion. So forgive me, don't ask, you know, the girl when you go and meet her, a sister, you know, how many rak'ah qiyam you are praying? Because come on, are you kidding me? You don't pray these rak'ahs, come on. Right? And then we have something very, very important. You know, after the marriage life, and by the way, ikhwani, akhawati, this is what we heard as imams, that Sheikh Ahmed has tons of stories, if I want to introduce him now, to tell you. What we heard that the husbands say, you know, Sheikh, you know, after 1 year from marriage, you know, I didn't expect my spouse to be in this way. I am sorry, sir. It is the same thing. Also, your wife didn't expect you to be in the same way. So don't just blame your wife, and don't, sister, blame your husband. Okay? Just accept him and accept her as she is, as he is. Okay? This is, ikhwani, akhawati, something very, very important. Al-Imam Ahmad, rahimahullah, he, subhanallah, he was very smart. He has another opinion, but his opinion doesn't reflect with the hadith, by the way. What his opinion? He said, ask about the beauty first, then ask about the religion. Why? Al-Imam Ahmad said, ask about what? The beauty, and then ask about the religion. Anyone? Yes.
Well, this is the face that you're going to wake up to every morning, so you will want to make sure it looks
MashaAllah.
She said this is the face that you will wake up, you know, every morning. Yes.
You know,
kind of.
Okay, the reason was, he's, yes. He puts what?
Nur
in the face that the one religious. MashaAllah, also. But MashaAllah, good point. Valid point. But his understanding, and listen carefully. He said, if you said to your mom, or dad, or my friend, I want a beautiful girl. Okay, give me 1 month. After 1 month, gotcha. Come on. I found the girl that you want. Really? She has, mashallah, you know, blue eyes. She's tall. She's this and that. Oh my God, that's it. What about her religion? You know, she's not that religious. So you know what? I'm sorry, I don't want her. So you rejected her because of what? Because she doesn't have good foundation, right? Not because her beauty. But if you do the opposite, which is, Mom, I want someone very religious. You know, help me in my deen. Okay, alhamdulillah, after one month, mashallah, we have this and that. Mashallah, she's doing 1, 2, 3, 5, 100. Mashallah. Okay? What about her beauty? You know, she's not that, you know, beautiful, but she's good. No. I want her 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So you rejected what now? Huh? You rejected her even though she has good foundation. Do you understand now the understanding of Imam Ahmad? Which is, ikhwani, as I said, this doesn't reflect with the hadith. With the hadith. Because number one, put the priority in your heart, what? The good foundation. Okay? Just let me give you a real joke. A real joke. We are sure we say real jokes. Okay. Someone came to an imam and he told him, listen, Sheikh, I want to marry, you know, I don't want to commit any haram. But, you know, as anyone, I have conditions. I want, you know, my wife to be, and he start what counts, what he wants. He put three, what points. I want her tall, I want her, you know, black, blah, 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 blah. Yeah, you know, the beauty points. And then he said, okay, give me like 1 month, 2 months, inshallah, and I will see what I can do for you. Wallahi, after 1 month, 2 months, he came back and he said, listen, I found the girl for you. I found the girl for you. He said, okay, listen, I will go through what you point. Number one doesn't exist. Number two, number three, number four, number 30, the man, you know, he's, you know, antakuna untha, to be a female. So he said, alhamdulillah, I found number 80. I have a female for you. What do you think? Okay? Okay. Now, why this? Alhamdulillah, I found my soulmate. Alhamdulillah. Now, we will go to the next stage, which is what? Okay? Khwani, we are now going deeply. So focus with me. The engagement. Mistakes. What are the mistakes that we do? MashaAllah, the single boys was very excited. You know. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help everyone, inshaAllah, to find the happiness in his life. Say amen. Mistakes. Number one, focusing just on emotions. And please, every point tell me, is that true or not? If I am exaggerating or not. Okay? Number one, focusing just on emotions. We have really a lot of cases. I mean, not every, you know, every husband and a wife, no. But a lot of stories like this, they just focus on what? On emotions. I love you, I love you. I love you. I love you. You know, you are the best one in the world. Yeah, you know, you are more. You know, I love you more than you. You know, all these things and another words here and there, statements, text messaging, and they for forgetting to mention the main things that they should discuss now in the engagement period. Right? Number one. Number two, speaking about dreams before discussing the understanding the reality. I'm sorry, before discussing and understanding the reality, which is something also very common. You know, what our dreams? I want to have this and that. They are just, you know, engaged and they are speaking about children. Come on. You know, we have many things to address before the children. How many children do you want? You know, I want two. No, I want five. You know what? No, you know, this is not right. You know, and the five star. So we have really very important things to discuss before, you know, we speak about our dreams. Right? We just engaged and then they start, you know, speaking about the wedding. What the kind of dressing I will, you know, wear in the dress, you know? What kind of, what is it called? Ring. You know? What I will write in you know, in the invitation card. Subhanallah, this is after maybe 6 months or 5 months from now. Just wake up. Okay. Lies. Because I just want my fiance to laugh. I just want her to be happy. Is that right? Is that right? Or I'm exaggerating here? Right? Now that you know the married people, oh my God. You know, this is I did this in my life. Like, huh? All of us. So lies, really. But why we are lying? Not because we are bad people. No. Because I just want my fiance to be happy. But is this an excuse? No. Just be straight and be honest with him. Okay. Hiding the negatives and just showing the positives. Hiding the negatives and just showing the positive. For example, I see in my fiance something, she did something wrong, she said something wrong, her family did such and such, you know, against our religion, or the opposite, from the husband's side, I don't speak. I don't correct. Why? You know, I don't want to create any problems now. We just, you know, engaged. Let me just dream, please. Right? Like, by the way, طيب means okay. And يعني means
okay.
Mean. When I came here in USA, in Sarasota, my English was disaster, so I was choosing, you know, one word in English, one word in Arabic. But I used to say a lot, يعني, طيب, طيب, even till now. So one American lady told me, you know, I really want to know what is the heck of your problem. You know, you keep saying two words. I really want to know what the meaning of these two words. Yani tayyib. Yani tayyib. So, anyway. Right. Healthy engagement. What the points that if I really understand and apply, I will do, I will be, inshallah, very successful in my engagement. Number one. Balancing between the mind and the heart. Balancing between the mind and the heart. Sometimes, you know, we should show our emotions. Sometimes we should be realistic. Right? We should be realistic. Number two, honesty. You have to be honest with her. Because all these things are your foundation as a marriage. The marriage foundation. If you didn't strengthen the foundation now, okay, you will have a lot of problems based on that. Number three, showing the positives and fixing the negatives. Okay? Number four, I'm running late. Explain your personality. Ikhwani, focus on this, please. Please, brothers and sisters. You have to explain your personality to your fiance. And you have, you know, the other party as well. You have to, which means how you know, when you are mad, how your reaction, how you address your happiness, how you think, what you like, what you dislike, you know, all these things. If you didn't in that moment, in that period, if you didn't explain it, you will put this, subhanAllah, pure relation in danger. Then, speak about your family. What I mean by speak about your family, sister, I'm sorry, you know, may Allah reward you. What I mean by speak about your family, you know, what's my family like? What is the traditions, the culture of my family? You know, we are came from this background, okay? We don't like, just an example, we don't like to be awake in the night. So, you know, I don't want your family to visit my family at 11 p.m. My family, you know, very this, very, you know, both parties. Because you are the ambassador of your family to your husband and the opposite. I will not understand the culture, I will not understand the, you know, the tradition if you didn't tell me. And by the way, I'm not speaking about, you know, you are, for example, American and I'm Jordanian. No, even if you are from the same country. This is our house, and here my uncle's house in my village. You know, two brothers, two families, we are very close together, but in the same time, they have their way, we have our way. So you have to explain and let the other party understand exactly. Because if you didn't, or you feel this is not important, your, you know, father or mother-in-law or the opposite will destroy somehow your relationship with him. Okay. Now, make Islam your foundation. I put this in the end, because it is the most important. I want you to focus on this, ikhwan. Make Islam your foundation. I don't care about your culture. I don't care about your traditions. Whether you are Pakistani, Jordanian, Syrian, Palestinian, Iraqi, Indian, I don't care. Our Islam, what my religion say here in this matter, I will follow it. Otherwise, I am sorry. Okay. Now I am married. Okay? Alhamdulillah. Now, the points, and this is for our brothers and sisters who are already married, and for everyone, inshallah, to apply it in your life. Number one, make Islam your judge, not your tradition nor your culture. And I already explained that, right? Now, if you didn't address this in the engagement, when the marriage life comes, you will not be able to control, you know, your life without addressing this before. It will be very hard. You know why it will be very hard? Because your wife in the engagement, which is, you know, 3 months or 6 months or 1 year, she used to live in a way, okay, maybe against our religion, right? So now if you didn't teach her, if you didn't inform him, you know, about the importance of this issue, when the marriage comes, you will not be able to control your life. How many minutes we have? 10 minutes? I will end inshallah very fast, inshallah. Perform certain ibadat, acts of worship together, subhanallah. This is very important. You know, pray in the house together. Qiyamul layl. Sometimes. Fast together. You know, as much, and take this rule, brothers, sisters, as much as you engage with her and do ibadah together, as much as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send comfort to your hearts. Okay? Why? Because you are doing things to please Allah. In the other hand, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will do things for you to make you happy, because you make him happy. Then, know your duties before you remember your rights. Just understand this, please. Know your duties before you remember your rights. You know, if your wife misbehaved or the husband misbehaved, you know, don't say, hey, listen, you should do this and that to me. No, but before you say this, just remember your duties toward him and toward him before you say anything like that. Focus on the positive before negatives, and we address this. Spend quality time together. Spend quality time together. You know, sometimes you really need to have, you know, some, you know, sit down together, talk, address issues, laugh together, you know, play together, play together. Why the Prophet ﷺ used to, you know, have a race between him and Aisha? I'm not joking. The leader of the Ummah was doing race, you know, he was racing with his wife. The first one, Aisha, won. The second time, the Prophet won. Why? Because, you know, she got, you know, bigger, and she said, because now I'm bigger, you know, and I don't have the energy that I used to have before, that's why. And he started laughing at, you know, not exactly what I mean. You know, but have fun together. Okay, don't get stuck in the same routine, please. Don't get stuck in the same routine. You leave from 6, you return, you know, 8 or 7 or 6, you have dinner, TV, sleep, 6, 5 or 6, return, have dinner. That's the routine. Just leave this routine, you know, somehow. Instead of you know, sit down with her in the, for example, in that room, every day change it. Go to the other room, you know? No, I'm serious, Omar, I'm serious. Try to change things in your home, okay? And instead you eat on the table, eat on the ground. You know, just be creative. And by the way, all these beautiful things, who started it? Tell me. The husband or the wife? The husband or the wife? The wife. Because the wife is more, I'm sorry, men, because they are more creative. No, serious. But we are the protectors. We are the men. Right? We are the protectors. But they, if you, sister, if you don't have that thing in the house, you will kill your husband. You will kill him, believe me. You will kill your children. So just wake up. I'm sorry. Show, I'm sorry, what?
A man can kill a woman.
I'm sorry?
A husband can kill or make wife grow.
Yes. Yes.
Oh,
I'm with you totally. Huh? I know. May Allah reward you. She said, man could kill her wife. That's true. And wife could kill her husband. That's true. Anyway, like, show your emotions, Ya Allah. Show your emotions. Sisters usually show the emotions. Wives usually show the emotions. Husbands should show the emotions. Okay? In many ways, of money, you can show your emotions. You know, whether you're by your sayings, or you do something to her, you text her, you email her, you do something nice to her, you know? And you just, wallahi, if you say to your wife, I love you, before you leave the house, it will make a difference in her life, in that day. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, before he leaves his house, used to kiss Aisha and then go to the masjid. Even while he was fasting, he used to kiss Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. It is a message of love, you know? A message of, you know, I love you, I protect you, you know, you are number one, blah, blah, blah. Confess when you make a mistake and apologize, and this is very, very, subhanAllah, common things, you know? We don't confess our mistakes. You know, instead we say, you know, my wife, you know, I did this and that. I was disrespectful to you today. To you, I said, you are crazy and that's wrong. It's really wrong. I don't have the right to say that. Okay? I'm really sorry. Wow. It is really nice. And the opposite. So instead of you start, you know, but you did this and that, that's why I did this and that. Okay? So don't, you know, just apologize to him and apologize to him. In that way, subhanAllah, يعني, you will keep this beautiful relation. Help each other with household work. Subhanallah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as Aisha mentioned, that he used to work with her. And by the way, can anyone describe to me the house of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with Aisha? Huh? It is like villa, right? It's like a castle, right? He had one room, like 3 with 4 or 4 with 4. Just, and he used to work with her. It is a message. It is a message. We are one hand. I really appreciate, you know, being your wife, being my wife, you know, and I really support you, no matter what's, you know, where we are, no matter what the time. Fine.
What the?
Never argue or fight. Never argue or fight. What I mean by argue? I didn't say never have discussion. No. You know, you are English speakers, right? Is there a difference between, you know, discussion and, you know, argue?
Disagreement.
Huh?
Disagreement.
Argue, I will tell you what I mean by argue. Sister, follow me please. I'm going to the left. Now, here the husband and the wife, okay? You didn't cook today. You know, this is not right. I'm working outside, and you know what? I came here, I don't find anything. That's not right. Come on. She didn't say anything. Follow me. See? Good. She went to the kitchen. No, come on. Why are you leaving? When I say something, you have to listen. And your mouth, and you know, after that, you have to follow my orders. She, you know, goes up, and this is, you know, argument. In the end, what she will say, you know what? Divorce me. Or the opposite. And I am sorry, sisters, after a lot of stories, the wives who argue a lot, and the husbands try to leave, try to, you know, calm down the issue, but she still what? Love, 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 love. And then he will get mad, and he will get mad, and he will get mad, right? You know, and then he will respond in the end, divorce me, okay? You are divorced. Oh my God, you divorced me. No way, I can't believe that. That's what happened. Okay? طيب. And then it is normal to have disagreements, but we must find a solution to them to so they don't grow. Here I have stories, you know, but I can't say all the stories. Don't speak negatively about your spouse in front of your parents or in-laws. This is, ikhwan, something very important. Try to fix your problem between you and your husband. When it grows and grows and grows, after that, you know, you ask a wise person from your side, a wise person from you, from her side, as the Quran told us. Okay? After that, if nothing, you know, work out, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us the solution, which is the divorce. Okay. Now, do not expect perfection in each other. Marriage is the joining of two imperfect people into one relationship. I will tell you now examples from the Prophet's life. Just some examples. I didn't count or put all the examples that I found in my research. Number one, the Prophet would drink from the same spot on the cup where Aisha had been drinking from. Subhanak ya Rabbi. She drink from this spot. The Prophet after that. And okay. You know why? I love you. Just, he said it without saying it. Aisha would brush the Prophet's hair. She used to brush his hair. Okay?
That's nice.
Okay. The Prophet used to lean on Aisha's thigh while she had her period. Why I put this here? Because some people, when the wife being in her period, you know, they even don't touch her. Which is, and this is, by the way, used to be in the time of Jahiliyyah, right? But the Prophet ﷺ want to show us that even in that, you know, in that time of her period, it is fine. He used to put, you know, his face in her thigh, you know, just to send a message to her and to everyone. Because Aisha, who told us all these things, Aisha radiallahu ta'ala, he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to take walks at night with Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would laugh at Aisha's jokes when she say joke. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would help out with housework. He used to know her feeling toward him, subhanallah. He used to know if she is mad or she is, you know, happy. If she is happy, mashallah, why you are happy? You know, let me share with you, you know, tell me I want to be happy like you. Or if she is mad or sad, you know, what's wrong with you? You know, just to make her calm down. He, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, used to feed her with his hand. Final advice, two things, before marriage. And Khwani, please understand these two points. Before marriage, it is important to have an understanding of who you are before you share your life with another person. What I like, what I dislike, how is my personality, how I act when I am mad, how I act when I am happy, you know, all these things. You have to understand yourself before you share your personality to the others. Number two, always resort back to the Quran and the Sunnah in times of happiness and difficulties. It is a guide for every aspect of our life. Wallahi ikhwani, if this point we apply it in our life, believe me, you will be the most happy person in this world. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who created you, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who knows, you know, what is the good, what is the, you know, the bad for you. And He told us, He showed us everything. Everything. While we are happiness in the time of happiness, in the time of difficulties, sadness, we should just go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Khwani, jazakallahu khairan wa ahsanallahu alaykum. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give everyone the happiness and a good marriage and a successful marriage in the married people life, inshallah, and the singles, inshallah, azza wa jal, to help you to find, inshallah, your soulmate, bi'idhnillahi tabarak wa ta'ala, wa Allahu ta'ala a'lamu wa ahkamu, assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.